गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द प्रैक्टिकल्स ऑफ 12th सिलेबस. वी हैव टू परफॉर्म 8 एक्सपेरिमेंट्स मेजर एंड 6 एक्सपेरिमेंट्स माइनर एंड वी हैव टू मेंटेन अ रिकॉर्ड फाइल. लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडे विद द फर्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट, दैट इज ओम्स लॉ. वी हैव टू मेजर रेजिस्टिविटी ऑफ टू वायर्स यूजिंग ओम्स लॉ सेटअप. सो let us first see the circuit of Ohm's law. In this Ohm's law circuit, in which V equal to IR formula we will be using between the voltmeter reading and ammeter reading, so we need a supply of the current, means battery, one ammeter, one resistance wire, this is rheostat and this is key. Now all these circuit components are connected in series one after another. Their sequence can change here and there. Only this voltmeter should be connected always in parallel with the resistance. Okay, parallel connection only of the voltmeter is there. Now let us connect it here in the lab. Here this thing is the battery. It has red terminal positive and black terminal is negative. We can keep any voltage, which is DC voltage here. We generally keep 2 voltage from here by moving this knob. We can switch it on and switch it off. Now connections are such that all these components should be connected in series. So this is ammeter, voltmeter, resistance wire, rheostat, key. So connections are: battery is connected with the ammeter, ammeter second end is connected with the wire, means resistance, its second end is connected with the rheostat, rheostat second end is connected with the key, and key second end is connected with the battery's negative. And across this wire one voltmeter is connected in parallel. Parallel because both the wire ends are connected with both terminals of the voltmeter. So this is called parallel combination, parallel connection. Now what we have to do, when we have to take the readings, then this key should be in so that current flows, this battery should be on. So as soon as we switch on this battery, in the ammeter and voltmeter the pointer will move to some divisions. What we have to do, we have to start taking divisions and we have to multiply with the least count of these apparatus. So suppose the pointer has moved to 2 divisions. So we have to take the reading 2 division and we have to multiply it with the least count. What is the meaning of least count? Let us understand. Least count of both the apparatus are calculated by the formula range upon number of division. Range means the last reading of ammeter or voltmeter. So in the ammeter the last reading is 1.5 written. So let us understand the least count. Range of ammeter is 1.5. Then least count formula is range upon number of division. Range is 1.5, divisions are 60. So this way 0.025 ampere is the least count of ammeter. In the same manner, range of voltmeter is also 1.5, divisions are 60. So 1.5 upon 60 means 0.025 volt is the least count of voltmeter. So divisions you can count like this: 10 divisions, 20 divisions, 30 divisions, 40, 50 and 60. This way divisions are needed and range is needed. So range 1.5 upon division 60 means the least count. Least count means each smallest division value is what? Okay, that is called least count. Now let us start taking the readings for the first wire. I have connected here the first wire. Battery is on. The readings are already shown on this ammeter and voltmeter. First of all, we will note down these readings in the table. Then this slider, we will shift somewhere away for the second reading. Then we will again shift the slider. Slider means this part, for the third reading. This way we have to take for each wire set of three readings. So you see now, if ammeter is showing 4 division, voltmeter is showing 4 division, ammeter is also showing 4 division just now. We have to multiply the division with the least count. So 0.025, 0.025. So 4 into 0.025 means 1, 4 into 0.025 means 1. So voltmeter reading and ammeter reading are coming 1, 1. So resistance in the last column is calculated by V by I formula, means Ohm's law. It will also give answer 1. So this is first reading noted. Then we have to shift this slider, suppose at this position. As soon as we shift it, the readings in the ammeter and voltmeter will change. I'll show you. You can see that here the pointer is this one. It is showing some divisions. Okay, so this divisions we have to count every time. Okay. So what we have to do? First of all, slider was here. We will take first set of the readings, that means divisions here, divisions here. We'll note down in the table. Then we will shift the slider to any random position, so that divisions are, we get the second reading. So here and here we have to note down. Then we will shift the slider at third position, suppose here, anywhere we can shift. We only want three readings anyhow. Okay, so now again we'll take third set of the reading. Now once we calculate the, take all the readings, that means three set of the readings, voltmeter, ammeter together, then R will be obtained by dividing V and I. We will take R mean. R mean is coming 1 ohm. After that now, we in the calculations, we have to calculate resistivity of the first wire, which is by RA by L formula. R is coming 1 ohm. Area of cross section is pi R square. And this radius will be given to you of the wire. This is measured by the screw gauge. So radius is 0.027 into 10 raised to power minus 2 in meter, we'll put it. And length is also given. Length means length of that wire which we have connected, that is 30 centimeter. We'll convert this also in meter. This way, substituting all the values in SI units, we'll calculate resistivity of the first wire. Okay, resistivity of the first wire. And in the same manner, we have this second wire now. We have to connect the second wire. We will remove this wire from here. We will connect the second wire across the voltmeter, that means in place of the resistance here. And in this, the same procedure we will follow, we'll calculate the resistivity of the second wire in the same manner. So two tables are to be formed in the file. Two resistance values, two resistivity values will be obtained. So the file work will be given to you. You all have to note down the file work with these readings, with the same readings only. Okay? So this is Ohm's law experiment.